Hey gamers, I'm Marchi from Cloud Gaming and Stream, and today I'm going to talk to you about how to cloud game 100% free. Yes, play over 80 titles completely free, no credit card required, in the cloud with no downloads or installs required. So I'm going to take you through all of the setup process, what you need to do to get all this working, and even how to stream a lot of these games completely free without any additional hardware. If you think that you know some of this already, you can use the links in the description below to skip to the sections that you might want a bit more information on. So let's get into it. Starting off with Google Stadia, we need to head to stadia.google.com, and if you haven't got a Gmail account already, then create one. Otherwise, hit the account here and come and select it. Once you've selected your account, you confirm it with the Google sign-in, and then complete the setup process. I've sped through the setup process here to save a bit of time. But once you've filled everything out and answered all of the privacy and security questions, you will then be presented with a trial screen. Now, it does seem to push you down the pro trial route at the moment. Regardless of what you do, there is no real way of bypassing this unless you know how. So what we're going to do is, instead of putting a free trial on, which obviously you're welcome to do, we're going to go back to the stadia.google.com home screen, find the Destiny 2 game and click play. This will now bypass that pro trial screen and ask you to get Destiny 2 the game. This is one of the free to play titles on Stadia right now. And this will then take you to the game screen, and you can now launch the game and play for free. Then when you come back to the Stadia home screen, you will no longer get that pro trial prompt, and you'll be able to just play Destiny 2 from your browser. You are playing for free, so mouse and keyboard is all you're going to need, but really the best way to play on a lot of these games is with one of the controllers, and both the PlayStation 4 V2 and the Xbox One wireless controllers are fully supported across mobile and also the web, and they have the greatest compatibility right now, but the next gen consoles will also get that compatibility soon. Now, because it's Stadia, you do also have the storefront, so you can purchase a game and then continue to play that game forever for free. But if you want another free-to-play title, the only one on Stadia right now, other than Destiny 2, is Super Bomberman R Online. Once again, you just find this in the store, hit play because it's a free-to-play title, and hop straight in. Unfortunately, it does seem to be quite hard to find a match, but if you have people that you know that want to play, it is the only other free-to-play title on Stadia right now. As far as streaming goes, even on the free tier, you are able to stream directly from YouTube now. So again, you need a YouTube account, and we've got some information on how to set all this up. I'll put the link in the description below. But effectively, if you are linking up your account and you see this error message, you need to go to YouTube and set up your first live stream and wait 24 hours for it to go live. But otherwise, you are then able to stream directly from your browser. Destiny 2, Super Bomberman Online, or any games that you've purchased on Stadia directly from your browser without the need of expensive software. And if you've got a mic connected as well, it will happily stream your mic as well. That about wraps it up from the Stadia side, but at least you can play what you want for free in a browser or mobile on Stadia and stream it directly to YouTube. The only other cloud service right now to offer a free tier is GeForce Now. You can head over to play.geforcenow.com in a browser. You can download the software if you want a slightly better, more fulfilled experience, but you can also play in the browser now, and also on iOS and Android too. So we're going to go ahead and set up an account using the free tier here. And if you use your Google account, it fills out a lot of this information quickly for you. But once again, I'm just going to speed through the account setup process here just to get to the next bit. GeForce Now is a little bit more involved to set up. There are quite a few more options to go through and also verification processes. So it does take a little bit longer than on Stadia, but it is well worth it. Once you've got your account fully activated, you can go to the mall and select the free to play section, and you'll notice that there's over 81 games that you can actually play for free on GeForce Now. So free tier plus over 80 games is quite a good match. We're going to pick Rocket League to start with here. And what you'll notice is we go through this kind of loading process, but what you're going to come up against quite quickly is either a queue, or once you get into the game, you'll realize that you haven't actually purchased it. even once you've signed in with your Epic Store account, and you'll get an error message something along the lines of "you do not own this game." Even though it's a free-to-play title, it's a little bit of a backwards route, but it's quite easily rectified as well. So what you need to do is go to the Epic Game Store, find Rocket League, see once you've logged in and created your account, and claim Rocket League. And if you could use the creator code CG Extreme, I'll leave a link in the description below, for any of the Epic games you purchase, it would be greatly appreciated. While you're there, you might also want to pick up a load of the other free-to-play titles like Rogue Company and Warframe, Cycle, and a few others that are also available on GeForce Now. And then when you head back, Rocket League also has some extra steps where you need to choose a primary account, so make sure that you go through the setup processes for each game prior to launching on GeForce Now, as the free tier has a 1 hour limit and you don't want to get stuck in login screens wasting your session time. Now you can get another session just by restarting the game once it's closed, and as always, you know, you can play these completely for free using touch controls or your mouse and keyboard, but the best way to play is with a controller, so it's definitely worth picking up a PS4 or Xbox One Bluetooth wireless controller. Something to note is if you play Warframe, depending on when they last patched the game, you may have a small download window. Now normally it only takes a couple of minutes to download all of the extra info, but when you get to the pop-up that says "do you want to speed up mission loading?" hit no, otherwise you're going to be waiting another 4 to 5 minutes for it to cache all the information that it's just downloaded, and that's going to waste your free session time. And it will do this every time you start up afresh, so you really don't want to be wasting that time when you could be gaming instead. Once again, Warframe also needs a registration. This one works fine from the launch window if you haven't done it ahead of time, but I would suggest that you go through the Epic Store Warframe if you're going to be playing it, and Steam as well as Origin, and set up your accounts ahead of time so that when you're claiming your games on the relevant stores, when you hit GeForce Now, you can just start playing. Origin is just the same, and so is Steam. You need to go and find the game. So we're going to use Apex Legends here. Go and claim the free-to-play Apex Legends. Obviously, you needed to create an Origin account first, so you do need to make sure that you have accounts on all the stores that you want to play. This is a little bit of an extra step that's required for GeForce Now, but again, it's only needed once, and it is well worth it. The other thing with Apex Legends is you have the ability to stream directly to Twitch, directly from GeForce Now, with the Origin overlay. When you get into game, just press Shift and F1 to open the Origin overlay, connect your Twitch account, and then from the menu on the left, you can hit Broadcast Gameplay and start streaming. You'll notice in the browser version, it doesn't let you enter a broadcast title, so you will need to use the mobile dashboard for Twitch to enter those details. But if you go to Advanced Settings, you can set it to the maximum at the moment, which is 1280 by 720, and the highest picture quality at 30 frames per second. So although not the highest detail, you are able to stream directly to Twitch when playing Apex Legends with no additional software or hardware. And as you can see here, it's streaming directly to Twitch, and I'm in the browser window for Apex Legends on GeForce Now. Obviously, if you want higher quality streaming, you aren't going to need to go down the route of using software like OBS and making sure you have a good upload speed. But for Twitch and Apex Legends, at least you can do it directly from the browser until you find your feet. Stadia has the option, obviously, from streaming any of their games directly to YouTube, but if you're on Twitch, this is the only game that we've found at the moment that supports this feature. I hope you found this guide useful, and I hope that you get into one of the platforms to start gaming for free. Obviously, they both have the Founders and Pro tiers to gain more games and also skip queues on GeForce Now. GeForce Now's monthly tier has run out, but they do have the 6-monthly version with a 1-month discount, making it $25 for 6 months with no queues, so definitely bear that in mind if you are going to be cloud gaming a lot in future. Thanks for watching, don't forget to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date with all the latest across all cloud gaming platforms, and we will see you next time.